top to the end. So when the tenor's back, he pulled back and ripped the flesh off his back. It took all the flesh, all the muscle, all the veins. He's back after 39 stripes, but the bones were exposed. You could see all the bones of his back. Then, there was a crown of thorns pushed on his head. Big long stone, inch and a half long, pressed into his head. It was an absolute agony. Then they forced him to carry a cross up the up Mount Calvary. He was so weak, such fear, he couldn't do it. Someone helped him. When he got to the top of Mount Calvary, he was thrown down on the cross, and then he was nailed to it. Like big, thick nails belted through his hands and through his feet. The cross was hoisted up, and while he was hanging on that cross, he said, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." Why would he do that? Why would he do that? Say that? For the people that had tortured him. He did it out of pure and unconditional love, yes, that he loves us so much, that he paid the price for our sins. And if you want to go to heaven, you must go through Jesus. That's why he gave his life. If you ask Jesus into your life to be your Lord and Savior, the center of your life, if you ask God to forgive your sins, they will not only be forgiven, they will be forgotten. This prayer, we call it the sinner's prayer. Father, I ask you to forgive my sins, and I ask you to forgive me. And I ask you, Lord Jesus, into my life to be my Lord and Savior, the center of my life. If you say that prayer, and you earnestly mean it, you will be forgiven. Not only forgiven, your prayers will be forgotten from then on before you. It's imperative you say this prayer, because there's only one way to heaven, and that's through Jesus Christ of Nazareth. He is the doorway to heaven. I urge you.